Hello. Welcome to Lenze Training. This tutorial shows how to set up kinematic and motion parameters for the rotary axis and operating the axis by internal control of Virtual Master. We are working with the Easy Starter and click on Settings. The main commissioning steps are shown in order towards the top of the tab. After we have checked the basic settings and the communication parameters, we will now set the motion and kinematic parameters. These parameters are very important because they describe the mechanical attributes and internal conversion factors and define the basic behavior of the software application in the i950, also called Lenze Motion. It is good to know that each i950 is based on an actuator according to standardized CIA 402 device profile. So that the kinematics and motion parameters like traversing range, feed constant or the setting of homing, manual jog and limits apply independent of the application used. So, first we will set the kinematics. We can click on the commissioning step or follow the linked text of traversing range or feed constant to open the interface for the kinematic parameters. Here you can set the mounting directions. Gear and or transmission ratio of the mechanics. By entering the numerator and denominator of ratio, the exact factors can be set, which are very important especially for endless traversing ranges. Please do not use rounded values for the ratio here, but rather determine the exact setting values from the gearbox catalog or data sheet. We will keep the default values. Furthermore, select the traversing range via this drop-down. We will keep it to modulo in our case because our rotary axis works endlessly. The feed constant defines the distance moved with one revolution at the gear output, in our case with 360 unit or degrees per revolution. In the modulo system, the cycle length must also be specified to prevent an undefined numerical overflow. Also, here we will keep the default values. Now let us go back to the motion parameters. Here you can set the motion parameters of the real axis as well as the virtual master, because our rotary axis uses the technology application sync and correction which can generate its own master value, call VM for short. We will set the motion parameters of the real axis as per our requirements. We have the option to set basic, homing, manual jog, limits and position controller parameters. In basic settings there are option to set parameters for halt, following error, target position monitoring, standstill detection and behavior in the case of controller inhibit. We leave the default settings and move on to the homing parameters. From this drop-down homing mode can be selected. You can see that by selecting the homing mode the active parameters are visible and graphically explained. We will select set position direct in our case and keep home position to 0 unit. We will now skip the manual jog in the real axis, because we will use this function from the virtual master. The limits are important in the case of a limited traversing range or in the context of extended safety engineering when monitoring limited axis movements. For our application we still go to the interface position controller. Here we can determine whether an additional external encoder, which can be optionally connected to the encoder module slot B, is used. It is important that in this case not only the control mode is switched to external encoder via index 0x500A90, but also the position controller for the external encoder is activated via index 0x500A92. In our case we use the motor encoder for position control. This means that the most important kinematics and motion settings have been done. Next let us take an overview of the technology application, for short TA. Click on the main commissioning step of the TA, in our case the TA sync and correction. At first, we are on the overview interface of the active TA. This interface view is divided roughly into three sections. The setting of essential control signal is located on the left. Important status signal is visualized on the right. and a simplified signal flow is visible below. Click on the signal flow to find more details like the source values and connected paths of signal to the drive. Go back to the TA overview. A device in a synchronized network of drives takes on the role of the master while serving as the first slave drive. It generates the master value and transmits it to the slave drives. In our case, we will run the rotary axis by syncing it with the virtual master. The signal flow starts with master value source. Here we select the virtual master as source. Additionally, we need to configure the virtual master so that the rotary axis will just follow it. Click onto virtual master. A new interface opens. Here you can configure the behavior and activate several operating modes and functions of the virtual master via the control signals. For example, the fault reset is used to reset any fault in virtual master. For this purpose, the status bit VM fault should be observed. VM continuous triggers the continuous driving operation of the virtual master. VM cyclic triggers the virtual master for one complete cycle from its starting position to the target position. VM load position loads the starting position of the virtual master. VM jog pos and VM jog neg are used for manual jog in positive and negative direction. There are separate parameters for this in the motion control. You will find these settings in the commissioning step motion, virtual master. Now let us jog the virtual axis by internal control. To set jog velocity, click onto motion, virtual master. Click on manual jog VM. We will reduce the velocity to 90 units per second and keep the other parameters. Go back to the virtual master interface. Activate internal control. Check the box of jog positive. Here you can see the actual position and actual velocity of the virtual drive. To verify the movement, we drag and drop the actual VM position into the monitor area. Now we will sync the real axis with the virtual axis. From the drop-down, select the interface of the TA. Before we enable the operation, we additionally place the actual position and actual velocity in the monitor area. Check the box of Activate Internal Control. Select Enable Operation to enable the drive and execute homing once. Our actual position changes to the home position. Enable Sync and to synchronize the virtual axis and real axis. From the current position, current velocity and the status signals, you can see that the real axis is synchronized to the position of the virtual master and follows the master value. That is 90 units per second. Next, we will go back to the virtual master interface to use other functionalities of virtual master. From the drop-down, select virtual master. Uncheck jog pos to stop the jogging. We can set start position of the virtual axis here. Let us keep the value 0 unit. Now click VM load position. The actual position of virtual master changed to 0 unit. We can also set target position. Let us set it to 90 unit. Now the drive will always stop at this position after the operation command is withdrawn. You can set velocity of the continuous mode here. We will make it 100 data unit per seconds. Now we will observe the target position behavior. Click onto VM continuous. The drive starts moving in positive direction with the velocity 180 unit per seconds. As we uncheck the option VM continuous, that is, we withdraw the operation command, the drive does not stop immediately, but it stops after reaching the target position. This is how the virtual master works.